Alright, good morning my fellow Degens. So it's around 7 plus right now and I'm at the fitness corner clocking in my calisthenics workout for today.
Didn't expect that from me, didn't you?
Today I'm going to take you guys through a day in my life during the summer. Let's get straight into it. I don't really have much planned today, but I'm just gonna bring you guys through on what I'm up to during the summer. Ever since the semester ended about a month ago, I've sort of been on a content grind, and I'm not gonna lie, I was getting a little bit jaded, and I felt that the quality of my videos started to take a dip as well. And with the new restrictions in place, it's harder than ever trying to make good content consistently week on week. I'm still really new to this. No matter, I took some time yesterday to recalibrate the direction of my channel, and I think as you guys saw on Instagram, I asked for some answers for a bit of research. Thanks to everyone who responded to me, and do follow me on Instagram if you haven't already. Apparently for some odd reason, quite a number of you guys associated me with productivity. Not sure why I really exuded productivity in my videos, but thanks I guess. So yeah, right after this I'm going to be cooking up some lunch and probably do a little bit of self-studying at U-Town. I'm not really sure if there are seats at the moment, but I'm just gonna try my luck. I'm also gonna tell you guys the background of my employment status, and in the evening later, I have a walking appointment of sorts with Amelia. You might have seen me shout out her channel a few times. And yeah, let's get the day started. Okay, before I do anything, I'm just gonna clear this up. This has never been my morning routine. It just so happens that I was feeling a little bit more energetic today, I would say. It's like my first time seeing the sunrise in quite a few months. So yeah, I guess you could say that I'm feeling a little bit productive today. So I just got out of the shower, and what I'm going to be cooking today is pretty much a staple in my life, and it's called aglio olio, or as Maverick from Ipu puts it, aglio e olio. Felt a bit posh there, didn't I? Basically, it's a simple pasta dish consisting of garlic, olive oil, a bit of chili, and some parsley. Usually, I add in some protein as well, like chicken or prawn. As an added bonus in my pursuit to become healthy, I also use wholemeal spaghetti as well. So literally, all you need to do if you're just cooking aglio olio is to stir fry some garlic with chili before dumping the pasta in. But nah, I've been cooking this dish for so long already, and I like to add some oomph into it. Cue the cooking montage. Okay, so before I head off to U-Town, I'm just gonna give you guys a brief overview and why I'm like unemployed right now. During the summer, especially so for computer science, most undergraduates would go for an internship in order to beef up their portfolio and resume. If you've been following this channel for a while, I think I made it pretty obvious that I was searching for a tech internship in order to clock the internship requirement for my degree. I actually started my search about the end of January and persisted all the way through to the deadline, which was around 7th of May. As you can see, I haven't actually been successful. It kinda sucks. And I
think it was down to a few factors, namely the semester being hectic, as well as my YouTube commitments. But I'm pretty sure it was also because my resume just kind of sucked. I've applied to quite a number of places and I barely received any replies. I did get a few rejection emails, and I actually had two first interviews which I didn't get through as well. I actually have quite a funny story about it. So one of the companies that I applied to was Shopee, as a product management intern, as well as a UX design intern. And when I got back the email, they wanted to interview me for brand design instead. So things like creative work, Photoshop, etc. Apparently after seeing my background, they felt that I was more suited for the brand design role instead of what I applied for. And honestly, I can't even blame them. In the very last week, there was one startup that I applied to that was actually willing to take me in. And I'm not gonna lie, I actually got a bit hopeful there. But after going through what the role entailed and whatnot, I made the very tough decision to turn it down. There are quite a few reasons to it, but I'll tell you guys more about it later. Meanwhile, I'm going to be starting some online courses that I shortlisted off Coursera, and hopefully I'll be able to find a spot in U-Town to study as well. So yeah, catch you guys in a bit.
It's like a ghost town in here, guys. Like really, really empty in school right now. I'm just gonna take a little break right next to this little cat over here. Just gonna tell you guys why I turned down the internship offer. I'm gonna boil it down to three factors. Number one, I felt that I wasn't ready. So as you guys know, I am a computer science student. However, the roles that I actually applied for were product management roles as well as product design roles. These aren't things that are typically covered in computer science. As I mentioned in my video about NUS computing, CS students tend to be software engineers, whereas IS students tend to be product managers. I've come to a stage in my college life where I don't believe that programming is the pathway for me. And that's why I was trying to pivot into a different role in the tech industry. I'm pretty sure my employability did take a hit. I think when the offer came in, I sort of underestimated the amount and difficulty of work that the role entailed. And because of my lack of education around the role, I thought about it realistically and didn't think I would be able to handle it. Which brings me to my next point. Number two, I wanted a break. I think most of my peers in year three kind of felt it. But on a workload level, year three was absolutely horrible. I'm not sure if it's because of Zoom University, but it felt like the module started to pile on more and more work than we usually had. And this itself started to compound as we had higher level modules. I can't even count the number of all-nighters I put this year as compared to previous years. The amount of stress the last sem was the worst I've experienced in my 3 years of university so far. And I think throughout the semester, I just kept thinking to myself that once this is all over, I'm just gonna take a break from school. And that brings me to my last point, which is the unexpected growth of my channel. Surprisingly, my channel grew a lot faster than I thought it would. I mentioned it before, but at the start of my YouTube journey, I was only aiming to hit 1,000 subscribers by the end of 1 year of YouTube. And somehow it has exceeded way past my expectations. The moment which really triggered this decision was when it was nearing my deadline to find an internship. The rejections were piling up, I was feeling more and more stressed, and I was also really worried that I would have to resort to applying to some place that I didn't want to be at all. The final nail in the coffin came when the startup couldn't offer the position under my internship requirements. And I think at that point, I was just like, you know what? Yeah. I'm just gonna do whatever the hell I want. I think I kind of accepted at that point that I was a weird computer science student. And with the momentum that I had with the channel, I was like, let's try to grow this thing, yeah? It's an unconventional route with a lot of uncertainty. And honestly, it's really scary because I knew that I really needed to have a proper plan to really make full use of the free time I had from being unemployed. It's also pretty scary because I'm sort of going through this alone. I'm pretty sure that majority of the people in my immediate social circle have internships. So I'm really in uncharted waters here from my point of view. But I will say this, not taking up the internship was the decision that I wanted to make. I made the decision myself instead of letting the fear kind of decide for me. There's this interesting take I listened to on the Mindset Mentor podcast, and is that whenever you make a decision, do it only if yes. If you're something like, I don't know, I'm only about 75% sure, then that's automatically a no. And that's how you know you're doing what you truly want to be doing. Do what you want with the information. I'm just doing what I feel is right for me. Okay, so it's around 4 plus at the moment, and I'm just gonna clock in a bit more studying before meeting up with Miss Yamato for that walking appointment. So yeah, see you guys in a bit.
Yes, that was you. I was wondering, I knew you. I got my peaches out in Georgia. I get my weed from California. That's that shit. I took my chick up to the North.
Yeah.
I get my life right from the source.
Oh my God.
Yeah, that's it.
Do you want to introduce your channel to my viewers? Come plug your channel.
Sure. Hi, I'm Amelia. My channel is called Amelia Yamato. I also do college content, but it's a little bit different, I guess.
Yeah, she's a straight A student, guys.
I'm not sure.
She's second. Okay, not straight A's, but she's second upper. Cap is what? 4.4?
4.4? 4.3? Yeah.
Hot damn.
Okay.
Filming?
Yeah, filming.
Parkour.
Parkour.
Parkour. Parkour. Parkour. Parkour. Parkour.
Okay,
so we're about midway through the walk and now we're taking a break at this park over here. So this is what I'm planning for the summer. Two main goals which I set myself for the following year, which is the next chance that I'll get to fulfill that internship requirement of mine. Firstly, it would be to beef up my resume and skill set. I already planned out a bunch of courses that I'm going to do on Coursera, which is a renowned online learning platform that is accredited by many global universities out there. The end of the course, you will be able to get this certification which shows that you completed the course. And these Coursera certificates tend to be recognized a little bit more than some of the random online learning platforms out there. It adds a little bit more oomph into your resume, but I think what I'm really planning to do is to get that knowledge. And perhaps when the next semester rolls out, I'll go and do a part-time internship as well. Secondly, I'm also intending to put out content consistently, as one thing that matters a lot in YouTube growth is consistency. So yeah, you guys can look forward to weekly uploads until I'm unable to handle it. I'm also planning to put out more vlogs, so you can look forward to that as well. Hopefully the situation gets better so we can get out of the house more often. It's going to be a journey for the next few months, packed with a lot of uncertainty. But it's okay. I'm actually pretty excited for what's ahead. And as Kelly Wakasa says, do what excites. Okay, so this is going to be a little bonus clip for you guys that stayed till the end. I am going to do a finals grades reaction video. So I have it in the universe. The exam results are in this application right here. I'm gonna click it now. What'd I get? Hell yeah! No need to tap out the module. Don't be like me, guys. Please study hard in school.